Carolina, who is the vice chair of our health subcommittee.
Gentleman from North Carolina is recognized.
I thank the gentleman for yielding time, and thank you very much, Madam Speaker. I rise to support H. Res. 271. This resolution, I would say to the minority leader, is a statement. It's a statement by Democrats of our position on the Affordable Care Act. It's not surprising to me that you would not want the facts to be before the American people. That's what this resolution is about. On day one of his administration, President Obama announced he would address the critical need for affordable health care for millions of uninsured Americans. He reminded us that nearly 50 million Americans were uninsured. Low-income childless adults could not benefit from Medicaid. Millions of seniors were not fully benefiting from prescription drug benefits under Medicare Part D because of the donut hole. He told us that parents needed insurance on their children to age 26. And finally, Madam Speaker, President Obama stressed that insurance companies were increasing premiums and not providing quality coverage, and they were discriminating based on pre-existing conditions, high co-pays and high deductibles. After much debate, we passed Obamacare. It has made a difference in health accessibility and health outcomes. It's not a perfect solution, but it has impacted millions of lives. We want to make Obamacare better. We want to make it more affordable. With bipartisan cooperation, I would say to my friend from Oregon, with bipartisan cooperation, we can do that, and we can do it effectively. But Republicans have repeatedly tried to legislate Obamacare out of existence with no replacement. This Congress has repeatedly said no to the bill. On February 26, Republican plaintiffs filed a lawsuit of last year, filed a lawsuit in the Northern District of Texas, contending that the minimum essential coverage provision is unconstitutional. And since Republicans removed the mandate penalty, the entire law is unconstitutional. That was their claim. 3 months later, Attorney General Sessions announced that the Trump administration wouldn't defend the minimum essential coverage claim, and that the Trump administration would argue that pre-existing condition protections should be invalidated. However, the Trump administration said that the remaining parts of the law could be severed or separated, and the law could remain intact. The court heard the case, and as we all know, it was declared, the Affordable Care Act was declared to be unconstitutional. It is now on appeal. On March 28th of this year, President Trump changed his position. On appeal, he is now aligning with the Republican plaintiffs and thumbing his nose, Madam Speaker, thumbing his nose again at this Congress. The Affordable Care Act, as the Speaker said a few moments ago, is the law of the land, and Republicans are refusing to defend it. Protection of pre-existing conditions is the law of the land, Mr. President. The final insult came this morning when President Trump confirmed that he will ask the higher courts to throw out the entire law, and that he will have a replacement ready the day after the election.
The gentleman's time has expired.
I am outraged and so should the American people.